For your mercy never fails me.
You can give 1,001 excuses.
Yes.
Why you're not doing well. Successful people are people who don't dwell on excuses. The word of prophecy cannot come through in your life if you don't believe it. Faith is the currency in our kingdom.
Yes. Yes.
The opposite of Nancy or Kunkun Yamu, the opposite of Niamh Nancy Diana, you will prepare a Huna Manu.
So good with every breath that I am able.
Can you bow down your heads in prayer? Father in heaven, we give you praise. We honor you. We appreciate you for all that you do for us.
Yes, Lord.
For the grace we have to come day in and day out to be blessed by you.
Yes, Lord.
We ask, O God, that this morning you speak to us. Encourage us from the scriptures.
Yes, Lord.
And let your mighty hand rest upon us.
Yes, Lord.
Even in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I am talking to you this morning on the theme, You are not condemned.
Wow.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You are not condemned. You are not condemned.
Wow.
And you know, everyone deserves a second chance.
Wow.
And for some people, they even deserve a third chance and a fourth chance and many, many, many chances.
Yes.
So I want to talk to you on the theme this morning. You are not condemned. Let's open our scriptures to John chapter 8, verse number 1 to 11. John 8, verse 1 to 11.
John chapter 8, verse 1 to 11. Jesus went unto the Mount of Olives.
Yes.
And early in the morning, he came again into the temple. And all the people came unto him. And he sat down and taught them. 3. And the scribes and Pharisees brought unto him a woman taken in adultery. And when they had set her in the midst, they said unto him, Master, this woman was taken in adultery in the very act. Now Moses in the law commanded us that such should be stoned. But what sayest thou? This they said, tempting him, that they might have to accuse him. But Jesus stooped down, and with his finger wrote on the ground, as though he heard them not. So when they continued asking him, he lifted up himself, and said unto them, He that is without sin among you, let him first cast a stone at her. And again he stooped down, and wrote on the ground. And they which heard it, being convicted by their own conscience, went out one by one, beginning at the elders, even unto the last. And Jesus was left alone, and the woman standing in the midst. When Jesus had lifted up himself, he saw none but the woman. He said unto her, Woman, where are those that accuse you? Has no man condemned thee? She said, No man, Lord. And Jesus said unto her, Neither do I condemn thee. Go and sin no more.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is a passage I believe all of us have heard before. And this morning, we want to learn a lesson or two from it. So Jesus was preaching, and then the Pharisees brought a woman to him. They said that, Jesus, this woman was caught in the acts of adultery. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There's a difference between adultery and fornication. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Fornication is when people who are not married together are sleeping together.
Wow.
Amen.
Amen.
But in adultery, one of them have to be married. So to a certain extent, it's a more grievous sin.
Wow.
Because people who are married, and to marry most often requires you taking an oath.
Yes.
Taking a vow.
Yes.
That I'm going to be faithful to you alone. I'm going to stay with you alone.
Yes.
Hebrews says that the marriage bed should be treated as a holy thing, as an honorable thing.
Wow.
So this woman was caught in adultery. Mm. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And it is said that Moses in the law said that anyone who does such a thing deserves to die.
Wow.
Amen.
Amen.
On the surface, you would think that the woman just broke one of the laws.
Mm.
That is, do not commit adultery.
Yes.
But actually, she broke many, many, many of the laws of Moses. Because for you to commit adultery, you have to covet something that is not yours.
Wow.
Are you here?
Yes, Pastor.
The Bible says that don't covet that which belongs to your neighbor.
Yes.
So there's a woman who is married to another man.
Mm.
And for you to go after that woman, it means that you are coveting that which is not yours.
Yes.
There is a man who is in vow with another woman.
Mm.
So if you go after that man, then you are coveting.
Yes.
And that is a sin. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And to go after another woman who is not your wife is also stealing.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because you're going to take something that does not belong to you.
Yeah.
So this woman who is caught in adultery has coveted, broken the law, has stolen,
yes,
broken the law, and then now has committed also adultery.
Mm.
And there are different ways we could look at her sins.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So that woman is never an innocent person.
Mercy.
That woman is never faultless.
Mm.
You know, a lot of times there are two ways of looking at this scripture.
Yes.
There are many people who see this scripture as an escape to justify the way they are living.
Mm.
So who is without first sin, let him cast the first stone.
Yes.
To trivialize the sins that we find ourselves in.
Mercy.
So none is holy.
Mm.
None is without a sin.
Sin.
So the one who is without sin, let him cast the first stone. That is how some people see it.
Mm.
So they trivialize sin. They treat sin as something that is not of value, something that we are not supposed to respond to.
Mm.
And then there's those other people who are also saying that the law says that when you commit fornication, when you commit adultery, this is how you are supposed to be treated. Let's read Leviticus chapter 20, verse 10. Leviticus 20, verse 10.
Leviticus chapter 20, verse number 10. And the man that commits adultery with another man's wife, even he that commits adultery with his neighbor's wife, the adulterer and the adulteress shall surely be put to death.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If there is a man who commits adultery with another man's wife, even that man and the neighbor's wife who he committed adultery with are supposed to be put to death.
Yes.
This is the law. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So God did not trivialize the sins of adultery.
Mm.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, adultery is not a victimless sin.
Mm.
The world now responds to sins or infractions that they think that there is a victim.
Mm.
So elsewhere in the world, if you should attack a dog, you can be put in jail.
Yes.
When you are driving through some neighborhood and you honk on your car, so you are making noise pollution, you can be fined.
Yes.
But when someone is caught in adultery, it is as if it is nothing.
Mercy.
But adultery is never a victimless sin.
Mm.
When you find yourself in adultery, you hurt your partner.
Yes.
You hurt your children.
Yes.
If you are in a church, you hurt the church.
Mm.
Actually, the whole Christendom suffers the shame of what you have done.
Mm.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So it is not something to be trivialized. So it is with fornication.
Mm.
So it is with all the sins that we see in the Bible.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the Bible says that those who commit adultery, both the man and the woman are supposed to be what?
Put to death. Yes.
That is God's attitude towards sin. And we as God's children must also have a very high attitude of avoiding these things. We should not trivialize sin.
Yes.
We should not trivialize stealing.
Mm.
We should not trivialize jealousy.
Yes.
We should not trivialize unforgiveness.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
There are many people who sit in church but cannot forgive.
Mercy.
One infraction 2 years ago, 3 years ago, but they still hold on to it.
Mercy.
And they cannot forgive people.
Mm.
This morning I'm talking to you on a theme, you are not condemned.
Wow.
But for you to understand that you're not condemned, you need this background.
Yes.
Sin is not to be trivialized.
Yes.
So you have been hurt, it's true.
Mm.
But the Bible encourages us to forgive. So forgiving one another, even as God, for Christ's sake, has forgiven all your sins.
Yes.
Ephesians chapter 4, verse 32.
Mm.
So you cannot carry hurts. That as for me, I am a quiet person. So if you hurt me, I cannot let it go.
Mercy.
As for me, I love people with all my heart.
Mm.
So once you hurt me, I cannot forgive.
Hey,
no.
Mercy.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
As for me, my problem is with anger.
Eesh.
My problem is with stealing.
Mercy.
There are many people who would justify stealing because they are poor.
Mm.
But the Bible never treats sin as something that is not supposed to be dealt with.
Yes.
So this woman was brought to Jesus.
Yes.
So that we caught her right in the act.
At.
But if you look at this scripture properly in Ephesians chapter 20, then you realize that if she was caught in the act, it means she was caught with a man.
Yes.
So the two of them should have been brought before Jesus.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yet it was only the woman that was brought.
Wow.
Could it be that she was framed up?
Mm.
Could it be that she wasn't truly caught in the act?
Mm.
It's also a possibility.
Yeah.
But it will just be guesswork. You cannot really tell whether she was framed up or she was really caught in the act. But she never protested that she never did it.
Wow.
So maybe she did it.
Yes.
Then she was brought before Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But Jesus now bowed down his head on the ground. He stooped on the ground and was writing. What he was writing also, we don't know.
Wow.
Maybe he was writing the names of the people who were standing there.
Wow.
Maybe he was writing their sins one by one.
Mm.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Maybe he was writing their names and writing their sins and they saw it. Or maybe he was just writing sins on the ground and the Bible says that their conscience began to prick them.
Yes.
They became conscious of their own sins. Hallelujah.
Amen.
A lot of time, it is easier for us to judge people when we don't judge ourselves.
Yeah.
But in the New Testament, we are called not to judge others, but rather to judge ourselves. Paul says that I judge myself.
Mm.
And my conscience is right with me. So one of the things you have to learn, I always tell people that you have to have a very high expectation of your own self.
Mm.
And stop just expecting so much from people. Raise the bar for yourself. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And don't expect so much from people. Number one, it will prevent you from disappointment.
Yes.
And then number two, it will prevent you from judging people.
Wow.
But a lot of time, we give reasons for our own shortcomings and expect people to do well.
Yeah.
So we are stealing because we are poor.
Mercy.
We are stealing because we are not being treated well.
Mercy.
It is only right that we do what we do. Mm. But for others, they don't have any rationale for doing what they do. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So this woman was brought, Jesus stooped down and started writing. Mm. The Bible says that from the eldest to the least, their conscience pricking them.
Yes.
Then he asked them that the one who is without a sin, let him cast the first stone. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The woman was brought to Jesus with her past. She was caught in the sin.
Yes.
So it was something that she has done in the past.
Yes.
But in her reality now, she was facing the consequences of decisions she has taken
in the past. Wow.
Friends, we have to understand that we are product of our choices, whether good or bad. A lot of us are very quick to ascribe every other reasons for our shortcomings, for the state in which we find ourselves, but to look at our own choices. Are you in church?
Yes, Pastor.
It is so easy for us to think about other things.
Yeah.
But never accepting responsibility for our own predicament.
Mm.
The reason why you are where you are now, a lot of them is by your own choices.
Yes.
Whether good or bad.
Mm.
Are you here?
Yes, Pastor.
Some of us are not married because of our own choices.
Mm.
Some of us don't have so much money because of our own choices.
Yes.
The state of our health, most of them, is because of our own choices. Mm. What we eat, how we treat ourselves, and a lot of things.
Yes.
And I encourage everyone to always look at our own choices to see how we contributed to why we find ourselves in the state in which we find ourselves.
Mm.
Instead of quickly blaming others.
Yes.
Instead of looking at other reasons but for ourselves.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I always teach that one of the ways you can be successful is to do proper introspection.
Wow.
To look into your own life to see, where did I go wrong? So that you wouldn't repeat the same mistakes. Because anytime you point your hands at other people, you don't accept responsibilities for why you are where you are.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then you cannot make amends and move forward.
Yes.
But this woman was brought before Jesus with her past.
Yes.
Staring in her face. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We all have past.
Yes.
Everyone sitting under the sound of my voice this morning have a past, have a reason, something you are ashamed of.
Yes.
Something, if it is brought to the fore, you wouldn't be happy about.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But thank God it belongs to the past.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank God it belongs to the past.
Yes.
Thank God you have opportunity to rewrite a history.
Wow.
You have opportunity to chart a new path for your life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This woman was caught in adultery.
Yes.
She was called an adulteress. But she was more than an adulteress. Hallelujah.
Amen.
She is a woman who can turn a new leaf and live a different life. Hallelujah.
Wow. Amen.
Someone is brought to Jesus as a thief. But this is somebody who can turn a new leaf and become an evangelist.
Yes.
Someone is brought as a murderer. But this is someone who can write more than 13 books in the New Testament.
Wow.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Someone is brought with all kinds of issues. You may be listening to me with different problems.
Yes.
Maybe you have aborted some pregnancies before. Maybe you have been in a relationship and you messed it up. Maybe you have taken somebody's money.
Yes.
Maybe you have had some opportunities and you have blown it. I came to announce to you that is your past.
Yes.
But at any particular point in time, you can chart a new path for your life. So the people saw an adulteress.
Yes.
She was no longer called by her name. Said, this woman is caught in adultery.
Yes.
She is an adulteress.
Yes.
But by the time she was leaving the presence of Jesus, she was a new person.
Wow.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And you also have the same opportunity.
Yes.
That in spite of the mess, in spite of what you have done in time past that is not right, once you are faced with Jesus, a new part of the book can be opened.
Yes.
A new sheet can be opened for you.
Yes, Lord.
A new place, a new dimensions of glory, you can touch into it.
Yes.
Only if you will not be bound by your past.
Wow.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Only if you will not dwell on that past.
Yes.
I'm saying that don't trivialize the past.
Yes.
Don't see the past as something that is not important. But you have to understand that you are not bound by the past. Hallelujah.
Amen.
All of us have past.
Yes.
But you should not be bound by that past.
Yes.
Let's read something from Philippians chapter 3, verse number 13. We'll come back to our main scripture.
Philippians
3, verse 13.
Philippians 3, 13. The Bible says, brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do.
I count not myself as having arrived. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is Paul talking. That friends, colleagues, I don't count myself as having all the things together. I don't count myself as having no fault, having no weakness, having no aspiration. I do not consider myself as having taken hold of all of it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But one thing I do.
Yes.
Can you tell somebody that one thing I do?
One thing I do.
One thing I do.
One thing I do.
And this is one thing you should do.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you recollect your life, there are places you messed up. There are places you are ashamed of. There are decisions, if you should get opportunities, you will not take again.
Yes.
But there is one thing you can do.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And what is that one thing? Said that forgetting that which is behind. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Forgetting that which is behind.
Yes.
Not letting the past determine who you are.
Yes.
You got the opportunity to study very well, but you didn't study. You messed it up.
Messy.
You got the opportunity maybe to travel. You didn't pick it up. You got the opportunity to do some business. You were not so serious.
Yes.
It didn't work out well for you. You got the opportunity. Some anointing was upon your life.
Yes.
You were doing the works of God, but along the line, you messed it up.
Messy.
But there is one thing you can do.
Yes.
That one thing is what to forget.
The past.
That which is behind.
Yes.
Maybe yours is not even something you are ashamed of. It's some glories.
Mm.
Maybe it was some successes that you chopped in some time past.
Yes.
There are those who dwell in the past and they always look at the past and say that, how I have done some great things. I have done some wonderful things.
Yes.
And all that they are talking about is the glory of yesterday.
Mercy.
It is of the good things, the beautiful things they were able to accomplish yesterday.
Mercy.
But Paul said, I may have done some good things.
Yes.
I may have preached to places where no one has preached. I may have suffered some pains, some beatings that no other apostles have ever experienced.
Yes.
But there is still one thing I do. I forget about that thing.
Yes.
And what do? I press on. I reach forward,
yes,
I reach on towards the goal of our high calling, which is in Christ Jesus.
Wow.
So there is a goal of a high calling. And that, notwithstanding what you have done in time past, whether good, whether better, whatever you have done, whether the glories you have experienced, the Bible encourages us to what? Forget that which is behind and press on towards the goal of your high calling.
Yes.
Don't let your past mistakes hold you bound.
Mm.
Don't let the devil, who is called the accuser of the brethren, continue to whisper into your ears.
Yes.
When the woman was brought before Jesus, she has stooped her head down. She was ashamed.
Yes.
She could not lift up her head
to
see a very holy man. And then he was surrounded by men carrying rocks. These men saw themselves as holy people.
Mercy.
And all that they were doing was accusing.
Yes.
Saying words of condemnation. They were saying things that you cannot come up.
Mercy.
This thing that you have done, you have disgraced us.
Mercy.
The devil whispers these things into your ears. You have disgraced God. You have let down the oath.
Mercy.
You could have done better.
Mercy.
They continue to whisper into your ears. They tell you things that what you have done, no one is expected to forgive you.
Yes.
But I came to announce to you,
yes,
that there are those voices belong to the voice of the accuser.
Yes.
The Bible says that Satan is called the accuser of the brethren.
Yes.
So the voice that whispers into your ears, that voice does not belong to God.
Yes.
It is not God who is telling you that you cannot rise.
Yes.
It is not God who is saying that where you are afraid, by reason of that mistake, cannot do better again. The Bible said that forgetting that which is behind, you can rise up.
Yes.
You can press on towards the goal of your high calling.
Yes.
You may have made some mistakes. You may have missed some opportunities.
Yes.
You started the marriage well, but by reason of some decisions,
yes,
the joy is no longer in the marriage.
Mercy.
The woman you said you love, along the line you made some mistakes.
Mercy.
You may have been following somebody even as you are listening to me, but I came to announce to you that you can make amends.
Yes.
You may no longer be fighting for the peace of your marriage.
Yes.
You have gotten to the place where you don't care whether it survives or not, but I came to announce to you,
yes,
you can forget that which is behind.
Yes.
You can begin to work for your marriage again.
Yes.
You may have gotten to a place where you don't believe that the business can work anymore. You have tried many things and fail.
Yes.
You think that your lot is to wallow in poverty.
Mercy.
I came to announce to you,
yes, Lord,
that you can start again.
Yes.
You can forget that which is behind.
Yes.
You can raise your head up again.
Yes.
You can choose not to listen to the voice of the accuser.
Yes.
You can choose to say that I am not staying where I am.
Yes.
Or you may have experienced some glories in yesteryears. I came to announce to you, you can determine that I'm not going to be bound by the glories of yesteryears.
Yes.
I am reaching up to the goal of my high calling.
Yes. Lord.
Which is in Christ Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
You can rise up.
Yes.
Notwithstanding wherever you find yourself.
Yes.
And reach on towards the goal of your high calling.
Yes.
The voice of accusation, it is never from God.
Yes.
The voice that says that you cannot do it. The voice that says that you have messed up so much that God is not interested in you again.
Mercy.
Look, Peter said, I don't know this man.
Yes.
Peter said it with a vow, with an oath.
And
he said, I don't know him from anywhere.
Mercy.
But the Bible said, when Jesus resurrected, he said, go and call my brother Peter. Go and call him. Go and call him. Go and call him. And he said, I'm going to give him a call. I'm going to give him a work to do. In the same vein, there's a man called Judas. The guy sold Jesus for 30 pieces of silver. And a voice whispered to him,
Mercy.
That this thing that you have done, there is no way you can be forgiven.
Mercy.
The Bible said that he purchased a gown. And at that very place, he hung himself.
Mercy.
And he was ripped open.
Mercy.
And all that was within him came out. But Peter had denied Christ 3 times.
Yes.
And Peter was still following Christ.
Wow.
Peter died. A mighty of Christ, even though he had denied him 3 times, but there was this man who sold him, and he ended up dying.
Wow.
There is a man, when they were killing the people, the Bible said that he held their clothing for them to stone them.
Yes.
But when he was dying, he died following the same Jesus.
Wow.
There is a man who killed in his bid to save his people, but after 40 years, he came back and then he was following God.
Yeah.
So it does not depend on what you do.
Yes.
It does not depend on what you have done in time past.
Yes.
It depends on what you make out of that and the decisions you decide to take afterwards. Hallelujah.
Wow. Amen.
3 times denier.
Yeah.
Jesus resurrect.
Yes.
Still following him.
Yes.
After the denier, when Jesus died, the Bible says that Peter said, I'm going fishing.
Yeah.
And he was able to convince all the other 10 to follow him to go fishing.
Yeah.
When Jesus came in the night, the guy was naked in the sea of Galilee.
Mercy.
Fishing.
Mercy.
Yet he could still come back to Christ.
Wow.
If only you will shut the voice of the accusers. If only you will believe again that you can do what God has called you to do. Things will change in your life.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the woman Jesus asked, where are those who accuse you? Where are those who are saying that you cannot do it? Said, Lord, none of them is here. The beautiful thing is in the verse 11. Said, neither do I condemn thee. Neither do I condemn thee.
Wow.
I do not hold your past against you.
You.
Wow. Do not hold your past against you. The mistakes of yesteryears are never against you.
Wow.
But the Bible says that if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation.
Yes.
If anyone runs to Christ, he is a new creation.
Yes.
If anyone comes to Christ, there is a blood that is able to wash all the sins, all the faults, all the shortcomings.
Yes.
When Christ sees us, yesterday when we were here, the senior pastor was teaching us that he sees us as holy brethren.
Wow.
Men without fault.
Yes.
Blameless before God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So if you are here this morning, then neither do I
condemn thee.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Neither do I condemn thee. Romans chapter 8, verse number 1.
Romans chapter 8, verse 1.
Mm-hmm.
There is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus.
There is therefore no condemnation, or no condemnation now exists for those in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There is no condemnation. You are not condemned. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There is no charge against you. Some of us find it difficult to forgive ourselves.
Yes.
Anytime we are praying, anytime we think about our current state, we don't forgive ourselves.
Mercy.
I could have turned things around.
Ish.
Could have changed.
Mm.
But I came to announce to you that the Bible is clear that there is no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus.
Wow.
God is not condemning you.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God is not angry with the Christian.
Mm.
Those who are in Christ, God is not angry with you.
Mm.
Because Christ paid for the wrath. The wrath of God was placed upon Christ.
Yes.
So the chastisement that brought our peace was laid upon him. He took the beating. He took the scorn. He took the disgrace.
Yes.
So that you and I will not be condemned.
Yes.
So anyone who is in Christ, there is no condemnation for you. And this is a truth that must be settled in your heart. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To those who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So Jesus said that even if these people could not condemn you, then I, who had the right?
Wow.
Are you here?
Yes, Pastor.
Who had the right?
Yes.
For these guys, they didn't have the right. But I, who have the right? Because when we sin, even though sometimes we sin against our brother and our sister, the true person we have sinned against is God.
Yes.
So if there is anyone to condemn us, it is God.
Yes.
But Jesus said that these people don't have the right. Because the very thing they are accusing you of, they are doing worse.
Yeah.
But I, who is holy,
yes,
who have no fault, I also do not
condemn you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And this truth must be settled in the heart of the believer.
Wow.
I do not condemn you. Galatians chapter 2, verse number 16.
See. Yet we know that a person is made right with God by faith in Jesus Christ, not by obeying the law.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We know that no one is justified by the works of the law. If we are looking at our own actions and inactions, there is no way we could be justified. There is no way we would not be condemned. Many people are in the church but still seek their own justification by their own efforts. But Galatians 2:16 is saying that we know, this is a truth that we have come to appreciate.
Yes.
That no one is justified by the works of the law.
We
have believed in Christ Jesus.
Yes.
So that we might be justified by faith in Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Have you believed in Christ Jesus?
Yes.
Have you believed in him?
Yes.
Then, notwithstanding the gravity of your sin, notwithstanding how huge the fall is, he doesn't condemn you.
Wow.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are justified by our faith in Christ, and not by the works of the law. Because by the works of the law, no man will be justified. By our own action, by our own trying to obey the law, none of us would have been justified.
Wow.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But once we place our faith in Christ Jesus, the Bible says that there is no condemnation
for us.
Wow.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God is encouraging us from his word this morning. That once you place your faith in him,
yes,
you are not condemned.
Damn.
You are not condemned.
Yes.
Romans chapter 4, verse number 5. Romans 4, verse 5. But to the one who does not work, but believes on him who declares righteous, the ungodly, his faith is credited for righteousness. Let's read the King James. I like the way the King James put it. But to him that worketh not, but believeth on him that justifies the ungodly. Are you here?
Yes, Pastor.
To him that does not work, but believes on him that justifies the ungodly. He doesn't justify the godly.
Wow.
I've told you before that it will be a mistake
that
all of you are in a queue
going
to the hospital.
Mm.
And then you see the guy who is coming before you or after you
said
that as for you, you are coming with a big sore and your sore is putrid. It's offensive. So leave the queue.
Mercy.
Because you don't belong here.
Hey.
You are in the hospital queue. You are going with your headache.
Yes.
Maybe you have a tumor in your head, but you don't know.
Yeah.
The only symptom that it is giving you is what? Headache. Then there is a guy after you who have a huge sore. And the sore is smelling.
Mercy.
Then he says that you don't belong here because your sore is so bad.
Mercy.
If he doesn't belong in the hospital queue, where else?
Mercy.
Does he belong?
Mm.
Are you here?
Yes, Pastor.
If the guy doesn't belong to the in the hospital queue, where else does he belong? That is why this church, alcoholics are welcome.
Yes.
Drug addicts are welcome.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Those who society sees and they scorn them, they don't respect them, they are welcome to this place. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because God doesn't justify the godly.
Yes.
But the Bible says that God commend his love towards us in that whilst we were yet
sinners,
whilst we were helpless,
yes,
whilst we couldn't do nothing about our predicament, whilst we could not rise up and do anything of value,
yes,
you know, in society people will run after you when you are doing well,
yes,
when things are working,
yeah,
when there is money, when there is influence,
yes,
when there is power, you will lack friends,
yes,
you will lack people who will always come and sing you praise. But when you are down there, when you don't have money, when you are not respected,
mercy,
when you don't have anything that they can receive from you,
people
will not come after you.
Yes.
But the Bible says that God commend, God demonstrate,
yes,
God showed his love,
yes,
towards us,
yes,
whilst we were yesterness.
Other
verses say whilst we were helpless,
yes,
whilst we could do nothing about our predicament, whilst we were at enmity with God, whilst we were, all that we were doing were things that God hates.
Mercy.
That was the time God commended his love. God demonstrated, God showed his love for us.
Wow.
Whilst we were yesterness.
Wow.
That is why everyone who is here this morning is an ambassador. You are an ambassador of this kingdom.
Yes.
To go and show forth the manifold grace of God to people.
Yes.
To go and show forth the people in the world.
Yes.
To show your co-workers. To show your co-tenants.
Yes.
To show the people in the world that God is not against them.
Wow.
God is not angry with them.
Yes.
God has paid the price that they can come into the kingdom.
Yes.
For he commended his love.
Hey.
Whilst we were yesterday.
Yes.
Whilst we could do nothing about our predicament. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you see that alcoholic, when you see that drug addict,
yes,
when you see that poor guy, when you see that sick person,
yes,
that is the very person Christ is interested in.
Wow.
Somebody may have a headache, you cannot see it, he looks dignified,
yes,
but he also needs the doctor.
Yes.
Somebody may have a sore, somebody may be coughing, he has tuberculosis,
yes,
he also needs the doctor.
Yes.
Somebody may even come there just because he wants to do a liposuction,
yes,
so that he will look better. He also needs the doctor.
Wow.
So when you get to the queue, many needs, but they all have needs of the doctor. That is why the church must be a place where people will not be shy of coming. The church must be the place where we will welcome the alcoholics, we will welcome the sick, we will welcome the weak.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It will not be a place where we will just sack people.
Mercy.
This church must be a place where people will feel welcome, people will feel loved, and then they can experience the love of God that is shed abroad on the cross for them. For the Bible says that he who justifies
the ungodly.
Men who were not godly,
men who have issues. God justifies them. And what is the basis of that justification? So let's go back to the Romans. The basis of that justification is that Jesus died for them. Jesus paid the price. So, to him who does not work but believes on him who declares righteous the ungodly, his faith is credited as righteousness. Galatians chapter 3, verse number 24. The Lord then was our guardian unto Christ, so that we could be justified by faith. So when we say there is no condemnation, what I am saying is that by faith in Christ, we receive that justification.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The basis of your no condemnation is by faith in Christ. You believing in the finished work of Christ on the cross.
Wow.
If someone is condemned for murder, and the person is placed in jail, and another person comes up,
yes,
that I am standing in the place of this condemned person, and then the person who is in jail is allowed to go scot-free, you cannot lay the charge against him anymore.
Yes.
Because someone has stepped in his place.
Yes.
To take the place of that condemnation.
Wow.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So anytime we place our faith in Christ, we are justified by his finished work.
Wow.
And this truth must be settled in our hearts. Let me just end. Like I promised you, I want to end early today. Let's go back to our John 8, verse 11 again. There are many things I want to say about this, but I want to end this morning. John 8, verse 11. Neither do I condemn thee, but go
and sin no more.
Oh, you didn't see it. He said, go
and sin no
more. Sin no more. That which will help you to be able to go and sin no more is neither do I condemn thee. Are you in church?
Yes, Pastor.
That which can make you go and sin no more is neither do I condemn thee. Anyone who is not fully convinced of the neither do I condemn thee can never go and sin no more.
Wow.
So when you realize that your clothes have been washed by the blood of the Lamb, and you are now white from head to toe, and you are loved and accepted in the beloved, so having been justified by faith, you have access. God accepts us.
Yes.
We can approach the throne room of grace.
Yes.
When we accept that justification, then we can go and sin no more.
Wow.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So grace, justification, is not a basis for us to live anyhow.
Yes.
Jesus told her that because I don't lay this charge against you, because you have been accepted in me, because my grace is at work in you, go and sin no more. Go and don't go and repeat the same thing.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He told us the other woman who was sick that a greater thing than this will not come upon you.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So go and sin no more. We are not condemned.
Yes.
So that we'll go and sin no more.
Yeah.
We'll go and live according to the energies of God that is available for us to live the victorious life that God has promised for us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Anyone who is freely justified, you see, the Bible says that to whom much love is shown, they can also show greater love.
Yes.
So when you fully settle it in your heart that you are justified, God is not against you.
Yes.
Because you are in Christ, your sins are forgiven. You are bound to be able to go and live the victorious life over sin.
Yes.
But those who are bound by their past. If you look at the lives of politicians.
Yeah.
Sometimes when they lose an election, you think that they will never bounce back. Sometimes they are caught in scandals.
Yes.
But before you realize, in a month or two, they have rebranded.
Yes.
Then they are back on the space and sometimes even being honored more.
Yeah.
Because they understand that you can be forgiven. They understand that things can be different on any different day for you. But we as believers, when we fall, we think that is the end. But the Bible says that the righteous falls
seven times.
Then seven times
shall rise.
Shall rise. The wicked is not like that. Because the wicked doesn't know that he is not condemned. Yes. The wicked actually is condemned.
Wow.
The wicked is a sinner, the one who doesn't have Christ.
Yes.
He cannot rise seven times.
Yeah.
But you and I can always rise.
Wow.
Because we know that we are not condemned.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I came this morning to encourage you.
Yes, Lord.
I came to let you know.
Yes.
That you should not be held by your past.
Yes.
Don't let the fears of yesterday hold you captive.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Don't let the things that did not work in time past keep you bound so that you cannot rise and walk again.
Yes.
I came to tell you that by reason of the finished work of Christ on the cross, you are not condemned.
Wow.
God is not against you.
Yes, Lord.
God loves you.
Yes.
And he demonstrated that on the cross.
Yes.
And by reason of that, if only you will rise, if only you will forgive yourself,
yes,
if only you will accept.
Mm.
You know, there's a man who was tried for terrorism in Nigeria.
Yeah.
And then the guy was being released by the court.
Mm.
In Nigeria or Kenya. Kenya. And he said he wouldn't leave the prison.
Mm.
And he's still there.
Wow.
Yeah. And now the judge ruled that if he stayed in the prison, then he should pay for his own food. The reason why he said he won't leave in the prison, he said when he leaves, the police will kill him.
Wow.
Because there's forced disappearance in that country.
Wow.
You know, when you are in the court, everybody sees you. His lawyers have been able to argue that he didn't commit the crime.
Yes.
But when you leave and the next day a gunman shoots you there, who knows?
Yeah.
So he knows what lies outside of the prison. Him. So he feels even safer
in the prison.
So he says he won't leave.
Wow.
So sometimes people have been released, but they are comfortable in the prison.
Yes.
So they are always staying in the past.
Mm.
Because of ABC, they can't rise. I can't leave. They are still there.
Yes.
But if you forgive yourself, that prison door is open.
Yeah.
You are not condemned.
Yes.
And let's show that same love to others.
Wow.
Let's let that love of God be seen by others. And others also should be blessed.
Yes.
I expect you to go out there as an ambassador of this love.
Wow.
To go and reach out to others.
Yes.
With this great love that we have received.
Yes.
Can you bow down your heads in prayer? You want to pray this morning? Talk to God in your heart. What is it that you have done that holds you back? When you close your eyes to pray, when you close your eyes to fellowship,